Well, good evening, beautiful people. I'm Reverend Christina Garza, and I am so excited to be here with you at the closing ceremony for World Day of Prayer that's also being co-sponsored by the Great Lakes Unity Region. So, buenas noches todos. Es un placer y honor estar con ustedes esta noche. Estamos aquí en el servicio de clausura del Día Mundial de Oración de Unity. Incluso este servicio está para también el grupo de Great Lakes Unity que nos está apoyando esta noche también por en este evento. So muchas gracias a todos por estar con nosotros. Thanks so much to everyone for your beauty and your love here tonight, and of course your prayer energy. So we have a great team with us this evening. Tenemos un equipo increíble esta noche. Tenemos primeramente el reverendo. Yo le digo que es un ninja de oración porque fuégate, siempre está con las oraciones. We have this evening with us Reverend Kurt Condra, who is the senior minister at Unity North Shore, and I tease him all the time and say he is a prayer ninja because he truly knows how to just cut right direct. He's like a martial artist of the prayer time and has a direct link to spirit. So we're so grateful to have him here this evening. Hey, Reverend Kurt.
Hey, wow, Prayer Ninja. I'll try and live up to
You already do. And
it.
of course, we have also who's my usual co-host and just an amazing, amazing prayer chaplain, Gaby Rivero. So, Gaby Rivero, que es capellana de oración, está con nosotros esta noche también. Increíble que ella también es para oración. Hola, Gaby, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, buenas noches. Hi, everyone. Good evening.
Y no la última, solamente la última, pero no completamente la última, es la música que está con nosotros, vocalista y compositora. Mucha gente no sabe que es compositora de música. Patricia Ortega. Hola, Patricia.
Hola.
So we have Patricia Ortega with us this evening. She is an amazing vocalist and also she's a musical composer. She writes her own music and has shared with us some of her own works, which are amazing. So we're thanking her for being with us this evening and looking forward to her beautiful, beautiful voice to guide us in this time of prayer. So with that said, I'm going to turn it over to our resident prayer ninja. Voy a ya darle el espacio aquí al Reverendo Kurt que nos comience con la oración, la introducción. So, Reverend Kurt, if you could open us up in prayer, please.
Oh, of course. Thanks for inviting me. So let's just take a moment and breathe in. And as you breathe in, what I want you to bring to mind is that in this space, in this virtual space, for the last 24 hours, there has been prayer going on continuously. We have had a number of folks here praying. There's been music. There's been reflection. There's just been a beautiful time of bringing intention and thought to the idea of moving into from fear to faith. And so that's the intention that we hold tonight. We open our hearts and minds that we can stand in faith and that we can move through this beautiful prayerful experience in a number of languages in a way that just brings together a greater sense of light and love and presence that we know is always available to us, with the assurance that that energy goes out and vibrates and resonates beyond our gathering here to touch the lives and the hearts of all those whom our lives touch, and even beyond that, to encircle and become a part of the World Day of Prayer energy that we celebrate tonight. So thank you, God, for the beautiful collection of people who have gathered here tonight. Thank you for our awareness of the power and the importance of the work that we do. And most of all, thanks for the connection that we experience when we gather together in love and prayer. So it is, and so we let it be. Amen.
Tomemos una respiración profunda después de esa oración tan hermosa que acaba de decir el Reverend Kurt esta noche y la intención, muchas cosas que tenemos pendientes que en las últimas 24 horas hemos estado orando, han habido muchísimas personas que han orado, muchísimas personas que han estado, ha habido música, ha habido muchísimas cosas y muchísimas maneras de conectarnos, ¿verdad? La importancia de la oración de pasar del miedo a la fe. Y con esto me gustaría leerles muy rápidamente la oración de la fe de la señora Hannah Workhouse que dice, Dios satisface mi necesidad, sacia mis hambres, su inmensa piedad, conmigo anda y es mi guía cada minuto desde este día. Ahora ya tengo sabiduría, verdad, paciencia, bondad, amor. todo lo puedo, todo lo soy en Cristo, luz del alma mía. Dios es salud, no me puedo enfermar. Dios es mi ayuda, no falla más. Dios es mi todo, voy sin temor bajo las alas de su amor. Y con esa seguridad que estamos bajo las alas del amor de Dios, decimos gracias, gracias, gracias. Y así es. Amén. Y así empezamos este nuevo día.
Tú quieres que siempre ha sido bueno. Tú quieres que no olvides nuestro amor, amor. Ruega por mí, ruega por mí. Siempre que estás solo, hazlo por mí. Ruega por mí, ruega por mí. Siempre que estés solo, hazlo por mí. I'm so thankful for every single blessing. I'm so grateful that you hold me in your loving heart. Pray for me, pray for me. Hold me in the light eternally. Pray for me, pray for me. Hold me in the light eternally. Ruega por mí, amor mío, ruega por mí. Siempre que estás solo, hazlo por mí. Pray for me, pray for me. Hold me in the light eternally. Hold me in the light eternally.
Qué belleza, qué voz de ángel. Muchísimas gracias, Patty, por compartir con nosotros esta noche. Vamos a leer la palabra diaria para hoy, que es amistad. So we're going to read the daily word today in Spanish, and the word for today is friendship. And the affirmation is, I give thanks for my friendships. So la palabra es amistad y la afirmación para hoy es, doy gracias por mis amigos. Durante mi vida he tenido amigos que me han apoyado y que yo he apoyado. Celebro el aliento que nos hemos brindado unos a otros. Qué tranquilidad de saber que tengo relaciones personales de respeto mutuo, afecto y compañía. Cultivo y fomento la amistad cuando hago una llamada a un amigo que está lejos o cuando planifico un encuentro para una comida en hermandad y comunión. El amor que he recibido de mis amistades me inspiran a dar amor a los demás. Cuando tengo presente el amor de Dios, sé que nunca estoy sola. La presencia y el poder del amor infinito me llena y me sustenta. Comparto el amor de Dios cuando ofrezco ánimo y comprensión. Comparto el amor jubilosamente con mis amigos y mi vida está llena de bendiciones. Y de Colosenses capítulo 3, verso 14, y sobre todo, Revístanse de amor, que es el vínculo perfecto. And from Colossians chapter 3, verse 14, which is one of my favorite verses, above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds everything else together. And that's the daily word for today. Rev Kurt, what do you make of that? What resonates for you when you think about amistad, friendship?
Well, I think for me, it's about how friendships have been impacted by all of that's going on these last few months. You know, there are some people maybe that we've lost touch with because they aren't as savvy with Zoom, or at least in, you know, in terms of our spiritual community. So it takes a little bit of extra effort to sort of reach out. And actually, Brenda, who was on the vigil most of the day today, talked about having written notes. She likes to write notes. So I sort of made that a pledge to myself that I'm going to write more notes, handwritten notes, because a lot of people aren't used to getting those these days anymore. It's all handled by email. And then the other thing is that I've noticed that I'm more connected to people that maybe I haven't been before, because there's been more time to scroll through Facebook feeds. I've connected with high school friends and family members in ways that I hadn't before. So it's sort of a both and. There's been this opportunity to deepen deepen connections that maybe had lapsed, and also an invitation to deepen connections that maybe aren't quite as strong as they once were when we were meeting face to face. But the value of friendships, clearly, it's nice to have that spotlighted for tonight.
Gracias, Reverendo Kurt. Es cierto que esta es una oportunidad para nosotros, ¿verdad? Aunque estamos en medio todavía de esta pandemia y estamos encerrados muchos tiempos, pero al mismo tiempo es oportunidad para reconectarnos con mucha gente que amamos, nuestras amistades, conectarnos en nuevas maneras e incluso no solamente renovar amistades, pero conectar con nueva gente. Es oportunidad de conocer a nueva gente que nos ha llegado por varias lugares o varias oportunidades que no hemos estado pendiente. De muchas maneras interesantes, ¿verdad? Es oportunidad para todos nosotros de conectarnos. Y para mí es oportunidad de sentir el amor, como dice la palabra diaria hoy. ¿Qué es el amor? Es conectar con Dios, conectarnos con ese amor que tenemos con nuestras amistades. Ese es lo más, más supremo de ser seres espirituales. O para mí es perfecto hablar de la amistad en este día de oración. So with that, I'm going to turn it over again to Patty to do a little song for us before we get into the nitty-gritty of prayer.
Muchas gracias. Esta canción que voy a cantar es para mi mamá, Josefina Ortega. Una canción que le gustaba mucho y se llama Gracias a la Vida. And this next song I'm going to sing is dedicated to my mother, Josefina Ortega. She passed away last year, coming up on the anniversary, so she's very present with me. And I dedicate this song to her. It's called Gracias a la Vida, Thank You to Life.
Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me dio dos luceros que cuando los abro perfecto distingo lo negro del blanco y en el alto cielo su fondo estrechado y en las multitudes el hombre que yo amo. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me he dado el oído que en todo su ancho graba noche y día, grillos y canarios, martillos, turbinas, ladridos, chubascos y la voz tan tierna de mi bien Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado el sonido y abecedario con él las palabras que pienso y declaro, madre, amigo, hermano y luz alumbrando en la ruta del alma. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado la marcha de mis pies cansados, con ellos anduve ciudades y charcos, playas y desiertos, montañas y llanos, y la fiesta tuya, tu calle, tu barrio. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me dio el corazón que agita su marco cuando miro el fruto del ser humano, cuando miro al bueno tan lejos del malo, cuando miro el fondo de tus ojos claros. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado la risa y me ha dado el llanto, así yo distingo dicha de quebranto, los dos materiales que forman mi canto, y el canto de ustedes que es mi mismo canto, y el canto de todos, que es mi propio canto. Gracias a la vida.
Gracias, Patty. Gracias a la vida. Thank you to life. Let's just take that in. Vamos a respirar. Vamos a inhalar y exhalar en este momento. Just inhale that beautiful energy in. Gracias a la vida. Thank you for life. As we open up this time for direct prayers. And so I invite everyone to, they'd like to share prayers in the chat box. They're welcome to at this time. Si quieren, pueden poner sus oraciones en el chat. Y podemos juntos aquí orar. Pero para que sepan, hemos tenido esta línea de Zoom abierta ya por 24 horas. So, la energía de la oración y del poder de oración está increíble en estos momentos. Y sabemos que la palabra creativa cambia vidas, cambia cuerpos y cambia el mundo. So, en eso estamos esta noche. So, abrimos y expandimos este espacio aquí ahorita con la oración. So we're going to take this time to remember that we've been here for 24 hours and the power and the potency of this space is absolutely magnetic. And so we're going to just continue that and know that we have just here in our possession that people have been praying for names that have come into Unity North Shore. I have 6 pages here in front of me that represent over 300 names and other kinds of requests. So we're gonna hold those tonight in our heart and in our prayers and in our consciousness, and knowing that we don't need to know exactly what those prayers are because we are connected to them by virtue of being one mind, one presence, and one power. And so we connect to them deeply right here and right now, knowing and affirming that all prayers are answered, best and highest good. So nos conectamos aquí en este momento, una presencia y un poder, sin saber exactamente todas las oraciones de la gente que ha estado orando aquí 24 horas, y no solamente aquí en Unity North Shore, pero por todo el mundo, en todas las iglesias de Unity. So sabemos y afirmamos que la palabra creativa cambia vidas, cambia cuerpos y cambia el mundo, y así afirmamos aquí en esta energía ahorita. So Reverend Kurt, I'm going to just ask you to open us up with our first prayer.
Oh, thank you. So as I'm sort of remembering what those 300 names, there are some themes that kind of bubbled up among those. And so I'll start with a prayer for healing and wholeness. So we take just a moment to enfold in our hearts and minds all those who might be suffering. And it doesn't matter if it's physical or emotional or spiritual. All of those are perfect opportunities for Spirit's power to move in and uplift and support. And so we call on that power now. And we know and trust that in body and mind and in spirit, there is nothing that God cannot accomplish. And so we see that process unfolding. We see restoration, we see renewal, we see receive vibrancy and a renewal of energy at every level of being. Because we know in truth that each and every one of us created in the image and likeness of God is born to express wholeness. And whatever might be blocking that wholeness, we see dissolved and released through the power of this incredible energy that has been cultivated all this day. So thank you, God, for our awareness that healing is at hand and that the power within us has the capacity to expand it in beautiful ways. So it is, and so we let it be. Amen.
Gabby, would you like to do just a very brief translation of that? A couple sentences for us.
Yes. Sorry about that. I had muted myself. Entonces tomamos un respiro muy grande y afirmamos que cada palabra que salió de la boca del reverendo esta noche ya está hecha. En el mundo de Dios no hay lenguas, no hay barreras. Y por lo tanto afirmamos y decretamos que todo lo que él oró ya es un hecho de salud y de bienestar para todas las personas que han llamado hoy. Y así lo decretamos y así es. Amén.
Amén. So I have a prayer request in the chat from Olga for children who are suffering in the U.S. and the world. And I also have a prayer request from Antonio, who's asking for prayer for those who are suffering because of a lost one. May their hearts be filled with God's graciousness. So, estamos orando ahorita para el sufrimiento, o sea, para la gente que está sufriendo, incluso los niños por todo el mundo, que Olga nos ha pedido que oramos por los niños por todo el mundo. So, tomamos un minuto para conectarnos y afirmar que la vida se puede ver del material o se puede ver del espiritual. Y aunque hay sufrimiento, sabemos que nuestra herencia espiritual es una de abundancia y prosperidad. Y afirmamos que todos los niños del mundo que están abundantes y que tienen los recursos, y que la gente que pueda tener más recursos o más voz que les ayude a los niños. Porque los niños normalmente no van a tener la voz como un adulto. Y sabemos, tenemos la visión que todos los adultos, que toda la gente de poder, que todos los líderes sean la voz, el portavoz de los niños. Y que afirmemos, que vamos a afirmar que ellos también tienen derecho y que ellos son hijos e hijas de Dios, con el poder y el potencial de ser completos y sanos. So we affirm today that young people, that youth, that children are safe and guided, and those with the ability to speak up, to be the voice for justice, and the voice for equality, and the voice for equity, and the voice for beauty, that they stand with children and all those that are suffering to be able to bring about a global change. Y para la gente que está sufriendo, porque alguien en su vida se ha departado, les damos confort, les damos valor y les damos un poco de sonrisa, que se acuerden de todo lo bello que han pasado por la presencia de esa persona y que sepan que Dios está todavía con ellos por la presencia y el amor de esas memorias. So for those who have lost someone, we just remind them that in this beautiful energy, that what a gift to have shared that love, like today's daily word, that love and that connection is the spirit living and breathing and coming through. And so it is, and so we let it be. I'm going to ask Patty to give us her final song. I promised to get her out of the service. She's actually going to be doing another prayer service that we'll share with you all at the end of some info to catch her again in a little bit. But Patty, would you mind just closing us out for you right now?
Thank you for having me be a part of this beautiful service.
Gracias, Patty. ¿Quieres compartir con nosotros cómo podemos apoyarte? ¿Dónde podemos encontrar tu música? How can we find you, support you, share in your music?
I'm on Facebook, Patricia Ortega, and Instagram, it's Patty Ortega.
All right.
You find me.
All right, find her.
Gracias, Patty.
Thank you. Vamos a continuar. Reverend Kurt will continue. So, next prayer you got for us. Rev Kurt, did we lose him?
Muted.
Sorry. One of the other themes really was for our country. So, we'll sort of combine, there are lots of concerns for the country, but I'm going to try and wrap them all into political and cultural injustice, and we'll just see all of that as a part of one big call to love more deeply. So we take just a moment to dive back into that beautiful energy that has been cultivated here all day long, and to even extend that beyond to the celebration that's been happening, a part of World Day of Prayer all around the globe. And what we know to be true is that love is the source of all that is, and that love stands behind all of the desires and the passions of our hearts, regardless of the divisiveness, that there are basic longings that every human heart desires, longings for freedom, the longing for prosperity, the longing for our needs to be met. And we know that as we connect with those deepest human desires, that we actually discover that there is more that we share than divides us. And so we pray that that commonality, that which unites us, is actually more powerful. It's actually what is driving the change that we see must be happening now in the divisiveness, that beyond that which divides us, there is a greater good emerging. We see an opportunity for freedom to express more equitably. We see the opportunity for prosperity and abundance to express with a greater degree of justice. We see the opportunity for hearts to heal and for bonds to build. And as we begin to release our hold on fear and anxiety that it's not going to turn out the way we think it ought to, Spirit moves in and creates a power and an opening for its presence to harmonize. And so we call for justice, for freedom, for prosperity for all. And we know and affirm that as we center ourselves in the truth of God's gracious being, that we open the door for all that is good and great to manifest for our nation, for us as individual citizens, and even for the world. So thank you, God, for the awareness that the power is within us to create the change that we desire. So it is, and so we let it be. Amen.
Amen.
Tomemos un respiro muy profundo y vamos a hacer una sola oración por nuestro país, por todo lo que, por la parte social, por la parte justicia, la parte equitativa, la parte cultural, donde sabemos que todo esto está unido por una sola cosa, que es el amor. Y a pesar de todas las diferencias que nosotros vemos, nosotros llamamos en este momento y atraemos a esa fundación de todo que es el amor, donde todos con este único componente creamos armonía para nuestro país y abrimos las puertas para todos encontrar lo que tenemos más en común que lo que tenemos en separación. Con esa seguridad vemos todos unidos en una sola voz, en una sola mano, decimos gracias, gracias, porque así es. Amén.
Amén. Gracias. Les quiero recordar, si quieren poner una oración en el chat, todavía hay tiempo. I just want to remind you, if there's other prayers you want to include in the chat, you're more than welcome to. What I'd like to do right now is just maybe just highlight a few of the prayer requests that we have. Many of them are very similar to others, but I just want to highlight a few because I think I would like to just keep that prayer energy present for all of us. And just to remember that all prayers are interchangeable in the sense that God knows, and that it's all one presence and one power. When we do love, we're doing health. When we're doing health, we're doing prosperity. And so all of them are interchangeable. So en este minuto quiero solamente ver la lista que nos mandaron. Tenemos, como les dije, 6 páginas de nombres o causas o diferentes oraciones. Y quiero solamente, pues, poner en alto unas cuantas, pero sabemos que todos son lo mismo. Uno, el amor es la prosperidad y la abundancia es la salud, y etc. So, I'd like to pray for, we have someone who requested prayers for Black Lives Matter. I have someone who requested prayers for all Unity churches. So todas las iglesias de Unity, Unity North Shore, incluso Unity Oak Park, Unity Chicago, todas las iglesias de Unity aquí en la área de Chicago, pero también todas las iglesias de Unity por todo el mundo, que está haciendo mucho, mucho en este mundo para abrir los corazones, los mentes de gente, para que ellos puedan abrirse al Espíritu Santo. So we're grateful for all the Unity churches that are in this time really doing God's work and opening up hearts and minds to the spiritual path. I have for first responders, todos los trabajadores médicos, todos los trabajadores bomberos, todos los trabajadores limpiando los hospitales. We're just grateful for all those that are part of this first responder system. For all those suffering from the coronavirus, por toda la gente que ahorita en estos minutos o han tenido el virus de corona, que todavía están quizás con síntomas o situaciones con su salud después de tener el virus. So tenemos todos ellos en nuestras oraciones. We have all of them in our prayer. For all those who have experienced violence and continue to experience violence across the world from any segment or situation, we keep them in our prayers. For Unity Appleton, in Appleton, Wisconsin, and I actually went to school for 1 year in Appleton, Wisconsin, so I know that town really well. We say prayers for Unity Appleton. And if anyone else wants to put it in the chat, I'm happy to do that. So we have also here, we've talked about the children, we talked about leaders, oh, and Unity Worldwide Headquarters, of course. We pray for Unity Spiritual Institute as well. We pray for the Unity Urban Ministerial School. We pray for the Unity Spiritual Institute, I said that. And of course, one of my near and dear to my hearts for Unity, for Silent Unity, para Silent Unity Latino también. So we keep all of these in our prayers, and I would just like us to just take a minute to just connect with these 300 or so names, these 50 plus kind of causes and issues and topics, and just rest in that. So por unos minutos quiero que nos conectamos con esa energía de las personas, 300 o más personas que están nombradas aquí en esta lista, incluso los 50 o más causas o temas que están aquí en esta lista. Nos conectamos directamente en estos minutos para subir nuestras oraciones, para bajar nuestras oraciones, para poner las oraciones en toda la energía en este mundo. Con nuestro corazón, con nuestra alma, con nuestra mente, estamos presentes con cada persona esta noche. We are deeply connected with every person in this moment, every prayer request, every pain, every need, every passion, every belief, every vision in this list and those thousands and thousands and thousands that came to Unity headquarters from all over the world. We stand firm in prayer, knowing the power where one or two are gathered in the name of the Spirit. The Spirit is there and the Spirit responds. And so it is. Rev. Kurt, anything else you want to close us out with here before we kind of move on from the prayer to the other goodies we have?
Maybe just briefly, because I notice sometimes in my prayer work when there are so many things that I'm holding in heart and mind that it can sometimes feel overwhelming. So maybe a closing prayer to just bring us back to, that awareness that there is one power and one presence. And it's not ours to solve. It's ours to simply align with and know that we are a part of something much greater and that divine solutions are unfolding, that each of us is being divinely guided to do our part and that love guides all of it. So it is, and so we let it be. Amen.
Entonces, una de las cosas que quería hacer para cerrar es de que todos nos acordemos que hay un solo poder y que nosotros todos estamos, que lo único que nosotros tenemos que hacer es alinearnos todos con ese poder. Y a través de ese poder nosotros empezamos a ver lo que nosotros deseamos ver manifestado. Entonces, el trabajo de nosotros es alinearnos con ese poder, con esa seguridad de que hay un solo poder en el universo, decimos gracias. Respiramos a eso con paz y tranquilidad, sabiendo que todo está bien. Amén.
Amen. Thank you, Gabby. So I'm going to share my screen now, but I don't know if I'm going to actually be able to do what I wanted to do here. It would it worked earlier. Now it may not work. I was going to show the screen to shoot. Well, I will just ask if somebody from Unity North Shore has the text to give number. We're going to put that in the chat. And so I'll just ask Reverend Kurt if he wouldn't mind. Just there we go. Thank you. You want to take this, Rev Kurt?
Sure. Current slide. All right. So we want to make it easy for you to support the Ministries of Unity on the North Shore. So we have a number of ways to give, certainly by text. You just dial a number and enter your credit card, and then it's a real easy transfer. There are donate buttons on our website, www.unityns.org. Or, of course, you can always just send an email. And I think I haven't talked with the Tithe team about this, but we had made the same at the opening ceremony. We had said that whatever donations we receive as a result of this World Day of Prayer experience, we would pass along to support the Great Lakes Unity Region. So know that we're really supporting the work that goes beyond the walls of Unity North Shore and all of those who have participated in the service for us tonight. So invite you to just hold in your heart and mind that generous spirit that we know taps us into the source of all being and makes us a part of the flow of greater good as you consider a gift for the Great Lakes Unity Region as a result of the support that you receive from Unity. So let's see. I
Aquí
bet.
tenemos todas las maneras de dar, si quieren, por favor, para apoyar no solamente este ministro y esta ministría, pero también para apoyar. Los fondos que se van a recaudar esta noche van a ser para el Great Lakes Unity Region, que es la asociación de todas las iglesias de Unity que están aquí en el Medio Oeste. Entonces, por favor, consideren apoyar a Great Lakes Unity Region esta noche. So thank you to everyone for being part of this wonderful, wonderful service and energy. We're so grateful to just be here together and be in one of the things that we all love to do and believe so deeply in is prayer. Muchísimas gracias por estar con nosotros y les quiero avisar que pueden estar con nosotras dos veces al mes. Estamos aquí orando dos veces al mes por Zoom. So you have the opportunity to come back and join us again in Zoom here. So make sure you go to Unity North Shore to get the info. Pueden ir a Unity North Shore para la página de web para ver toda la información y para inscribirse a nuestros anuncios. So thank you so much to everyone. Love you all. And I'm going to turn it over to Gavi to close us out, and then we can chat and open up afterwards.
Yes, thank you everyone for joining us tonight. Gracias por haberse unido a nosotros esta noche. Let's do now the prayer for protection. Vamos a hacer ahora la oración de protección todos juntos. La luz de Dios nos rodea. Yo soy luz. El amor de Dios nos envuelve. Yo soy amor. El poder de Dios nos protege. Yo soy poder. La presencia de Dios vela por nosotros. Yo soy presencia. Donde quiera que estamos, está Dios. Yo soy divino. And now in English. The light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence. Whatever we are, God is. I am divine.
Hey, thanks for watching this YouTube video. If Unity's message of positive spiritual living resonates with you, I hope you'll subscribe to our channel so you can stay up to date on other lessons as we post them. Also, if you're able to support us financially in the work that we do in the world, please check below for contact information. You can visit our website, find more about what programming we offer, as well as how to give. Blessings.